Hello, my name is Dr. Pankaj Gupta. I am currently the president of IIHMR University. It is based in Jaipur. It is a premier university in the area of healthcare, hospital, pharma, and rural management. And we were set up in collaboration with the Johns Hopkins University, Baltimore in the US. So we do programs, MBA in healthcare, hospital, and all these allied fields. And we are primarily a research focused university, and our alumnus are working all over the world. And prior to this, I was working with OP Jindal Global University, and I've also worked with IIM Kozhikode, IMT Symbiosis, University of Washington in US, just to give a quick introduction about.
Well, that's a wonderful list of great institutions that you've worked with. And
I've been just lucky enough, you know.
Well, not everybody gets as lucky as you are.
No, okay.
So, a quick take about the annual convention in 2019 of ASMA. How do you think this has come out, and what's the major takeaways?
I think it is a very, very good initiative taken by Rahul ji and the whole team. I see that a lot of, you know, the upcoming technology in the EdTech segment, and technologies which can make an impact, not only the current best practices but also the next practices. I can see that that a very good galaxy of those initiatives are here, and I can also see that a lot of, you know, the decision makers are here. Like if you talk about any other normal convention, all people will be there, but I see that this convention is focused only for the industry leaders and the decision makers. They make it a very, very unique kind of conglomeration of academic leaders and the EdTech people here.
Well, sir, thank you so much for your thoughts on that. Why do you think, sir, digital transformation in the higher education is important, first of all, and the summits like this, you know, in the future to come? How do you think they have the relevance?
See, change is the only constant thing in this world, and the organization which have not changed over a period of time, they all have become obsolete. We know example of Kodak, and so many examples are there. So we need to engage with the youth, and you see that all the youth are on the mobile phone and digital way. So it has gone out the days that when you talk only about the paper based and books, we need to change as per the requirement. Moreover, gone are the days that when you talk about the gurus there giving some talk, sharing from the notes which they prepared for many, many years back. These are no longer the time. And also the things are quite changing from the information based to the wisdom based. And for the information based, you need to have a lot of information, everything at your fingertips. And the accessibility and ease of use is very much important. And gone are the days when you talk about giving one advertisement in the newspaper and people are applying. It is not like that. You need to continuously engage with the people who want to apply to you. And they also want to know, okay, how much and what are you posting on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and accordingly they take a decision. Gone are the days when you just publish an advertisement and say, okay, that is how, you know, I do this thing. But now they are not only just interested in that advertisement, but they would like to see it day in and day out. What is the reaction of my other student who are already studying in that university or the institution? So seeing is believing. The continuous engagement is the way out. So it is reflecting either in the alumni relation or the new enrollment or the knowledge delivery, maybe whatever, even the fundraising, operation management in the institution. In all these important areas, the value creation is very important. And if you also talk about from the balanced scorecard model, the learning and growth, the internal business process, you talk about customer delight, and then leading to the financial outcome. I believe in all the four important dimensions, the digitalization has to play a very, very important role. So I believe it is the future, and the writing is very clear on the wall. So I would like to once again compliment Mr. Rahul and the whole ASMA team for doing this wonderful convention and taking this wonderful initiative. So my best wishes.
So very well said. Actually, we are building a community here, like you said, with students and youngsters being on social media and their digital devices. What is the message that you want to give to them about, you know, from your side towards the digitalization of all the academic issues?
I believe, you know, the time is now. There was a study being conducted in a leading university in the US, and they said you live only 18%. So where is 82% going? It is again either in the regret of the past or anxiety about the future. So the time to live is now, living it fully right now, right here. So in this way, if you're living it in a meaningful way and not only thinking, oh, mobile phone students are using, it is a disruption, it is no longer disruption. You need to make friends with the technology, and you have to be as the flow is going. And so there is a time that teachers and all the users, administrators, the owners, they all have to adopt to this whole revolution, which is already here, that is going to stay here, be it artificial intelligence or use of big data or use of the blockchain technology. They all are here, or the use of the CRM in placement, admissions, or in the fundraising. It is all going to stay here. So all the best.
Well, I hope you inspire people to adapt to the way you're thinking. It is absolutely the right need of the hour. Well, a quick fun question, sir. Let's do this. Let's assume that ASMA was 20 years behind, and that time probably you were out of the college or starting your career. How would ASMA look like, the convention look like then?
It is very difficult to, you know, think like that, but maybe the same old model, you know, the newspaper, this, you know, brochures, sending this and that. And moreover, at that time, there was also not so much of competition there, because still the, you know, the demand was more and the supply was less. And at that time, mainly it was being driven mainly by the government colleges and all. So maybe at that time, institution like ASMA may not be in that much relevance. I feel so, but right now it is in great in relevance. And I think if you talk about maybe 20 years hence, it would be, you know, I need not to say anything. Everybody will be thinking that the way they have transformed the whole system and how the entire habits are changed, the way the social media, the engagement and the transformation is taking place. So I wish all the best.
Well, I absolutely love the way you spoke. It was so apt and so to the point. And that's what we need. People like you to come and guide us, not only guide us, mentor us, and bring the future to today. I thank you so much for your time.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Really appreciate it.